The biggest club against the richest. The Melbourne Derby has found a narrative ever since the City Football Group took control at City. But success has belonged exclusively to victory. Is this the definitive derby for Melbourne's other team? The day they lay down a marker, or will the champions put them firmly back in their place? It is a night filled with those sorts of questions. Are victory's neighbours about to become just a little noisier? The Melbourne victory, of course, won't care too much. They'll have the numbers in the stands. 25,000 memberships sold ahead of the new season. And, of course, they can wallow in the memory of their 3-0 finals drubbing of their City rivals just a few months ago. City fans, though, on the way into the stadium, full of confidence, impressed by the way their team has tackled the pre-season, the FFA Cup in particular, and a useful point earned at Sydney FC on opening night. Skeptics may say this fixture has no history, that the clubs are manufactured, that the rivalry is false, but there is no doubt this game is big box office on a perfect Melbourne night, temperatures of 16 degrees, and a crowd of over 40,000 expected to be here again tonight. And although the majority, as we say, will again wear navy blue, there is the feeling that on the pitch at least, Andy Harper, City could just give victory a run for their money this season.
And Simon, good evening. That's where it counts, on the pitch, of course. There'll be a lot of argy-bargy, verbal argy-bargy in the stands, but on the pitch is where the business will be decided, and Melbourne City looking as good as they've done in any of their incarnations, either as Melbourne Heart or since the City Football Group took over. Melbourne, victory for their part, the vending champions, looking every inch the champions in their defence at the moment. And, of course, with the prospect as the FFA Cup semi-finals come up on the horizon of another clash not too far down the track. But let's enjoy this one first. It'll be a crack.
And it is City to come out first. The teams will come out individually. So here we go, Melbourne, the self-proclaimed sporting capital of Australia. And in A-League terms, this is the game that has come to define this city. The away team out first, to be followed by Melbourne victory when the roof will be raised. It's open tonight, which is good because temperatures are perfect and the surface is good. Melbourne victory fans awaiting their team. Strap yourself in for the 17th Melbourne Derby. Victory up against City. A wall of noise, lots of colour, a city divided on Derby Day. Stand By Me has become victory's anthem. Melbourne City looking to stand up to the challenge of the champions. Let's take a check on the two teams, starting with the victory. And the question all week for Kevin Muscat was, who would replace the suspended Lee Broxham? In the end, he's plunked for teenager Thomas Deng to partner Mathieu Delpierre. The Nairobi-born Deng making his full debut in the A-League in front of 40,000, a great show of faith by his coach. In other news, Carl Valeri returns after injury to lead the team for the first time on a full-time basis. Those the only victory changes, with Rashid Mahazi, the unlucky man, to drop down to the bench. Kevin Muscat enjoyed 3 wins out of 4 against the neighbours last season. His team smashing in 11 goals in the process, all at this venue. He'll celebrate 2 years as head coach of victory at the end of the month. And it is 6 years ago this week that John Van Skip was first signed by the then Melbourne Heart to lead them in their inaugural season. His stock could well rise considerably by the end of the week if they can win the derby, and he can guide City into the FFA Cup final at Perth's expense on Wednesday. Match referee is full-timer Jared Gillets, whose last appearance in Melbourne was the grand final back in May. Assisting him today, Nathan McDonald, Luke Brennan, and fourth official Jonathan Barrera. Thomas Sorensen made more saves than any other goalkeeper in round 1 of the Hyundai A-League. And he's well used to derbies, of course, played in the Sunderland-Newcastle fixture many times, and for Aston Villa against Birmingham in that derby as well. And a milestone for Danny Vukovic and the A-League tonight. He breaks the A-League record, his 229th game in the competition, thus easing him past his former Mariners teammate, John Hutchinson. Congratulations to him. So it's Melbourne City in all white to get us underway. Battle has commenced again between these two city rivals. Victory, certain contenders, according to most people, again this season. But what of City? Contenders or pretenders, Andy?
No, on the evidence of last week, Simon, definite contenders. Of course, we always used to talk about Melbourne Heart stroke Melbourne City, them wanting to have Derby Day every week because it's when they played their best. Well, certainly hope they bring their derby form and build upon it. What they achieved last week in Sydney, a really impressive display against a very good Sydney FC team. And a wonderful theatre here. Great crowd, good noise, plenty of colour and movement.
Yeah, the restaurants and bars were packed to capacity in the build-up to this fixture. Always one of those games that you really look forward to, whether you support one of the two clubs or not. And hasn't it provided some great theatre in its 4 years? Seems as though it's been with us a lot longer. For each other there, but they've sorted it out. Victory. This is Barbarousis. He's got the better of two Victory defenders there. City defenders, I should say. Cross it in towards Berisha, and Moy was back in time to nick it away from Finkler. There seemed no room for manoeuvre really there for Costa Barbarousis, who did brilliantly. Bozanic. Georgievski. Time to venture forward. Little layoff by Berisha. Kalfala deflection. Goal. Victory lead. The midway point of the first half. Fahid Ben Kalfala's shot took a mighty deflection and wrong-footed Thomas Sorensen. Victory don't care. They lead the derby.
Well, not a lot of surprise, the origin of this goal. Look at the penetrating run of Daniel Georgievski. He's been very positive all night. Fires the ball into Berisha, who's been happy to play the bouncing board here so far this evening. And the other star of the opening proceedings, Fahid Ben Kalfala, the shot probably going wide in truth. But there's nothing Thomas Sorensen can do after Paolo Retre inadvertently touches that ball into his own net.
First goal of the new season for those Victory fans to cheer. And it's possible it will be credited as an own goal as Vukovic with a loose clearance. City could be back in here for an equaliser. Vukovic atones by saving the follow-up effort from Robbie Corrin. The blue touch paper lit in the 17th Melbourne derby.
From 1 to 11 accept their responsibility, particularly when they're going forward. And none of their attackers are looking to hide. They're always looking to hurt their opponents. Well, Melbourne City need to take more of a leaf out of their book. The individuals concerned have started better in this second half and can certainly get something if they continue in that vein.
Finkler between the lines. Bartolo to head it clear. And for a second time. Fornaroli again playing permanently with his back to Mathieu Delpierre. and is not able to hold the ball up for City and invite more pressure. It's Kelfalar who floats it to the back post, and there's Costa Barbarousis for the second, and Victory have a two-goal cushion, and it's a long way back now for Melbourne City. Barbarousis scores for the third derby in a row. And a delicious ball in from Kelfalar.
Well, look how wide the Victory formation is, and they've stretched Melbourne City, and Kelfalar jinks inside and just hits the perfect flight on that cross. Jack Clisby again questions about his starting position in retreat. Costa Barbarousis beating you in the air on the back stick. Reasons for an inquiry. It's a very tidy header from the Kiwi international nonetheless.
Strong run down that left-hand side by Kisnorba, of all people. Now Moore, top of the box, Fonaroli, great turn, and there's a goal for Melbourne City. And it is a super finish by the Uruguayan, 2-1. That is goal poaching at its very best. What a turn, and the finish wasn't bad either.
Well, it was Patrick Kisnorbo, if you can believe it, leading the charge down the left flank. And the exchange between Moore, beautiful shift of weight. That is exquisite. And that he got to the ball before Danny Vukovic is almost as breathtaking. Melbourne City, the cry goes out, give him some help. Give Bruno some help. What a fabulous finish.
Well, he scored three times in the FFA Cup, Bruno Fornaroli, but that one much more valuable, and it brings this Melbourne derby back to life. A name to remember for this season, Bruno Fornaroli. There could be it again here. Chapman is offside, unfortunately, for City.
Well, I hope that this goal from Bruno Fornaroli is replayed to Australian youngsters ad nauseam. That is a sensational turn. And who was on his back? Mathieu Delpierre. So make no mistake, the quality of that finish. And as a collector's item, what about the run from Patrick Kisnorba? That's nosebleed territory.
They've got a bit of a spring in their step now, Melbourne City. Derby that's looked to be getting away from them. They've still got work to do, but they've started the journey. Talked about the turn, Andy, but what about the determination as well, with Vukovic bearing down on you? He was not going to be denied.
Well, I'd venture to suggest that the acceleration he showed even caught Danny Vukovic by surprise. Vukovic, the way he came out for that ball, thought he was odds on to win it. From nowhere, brilliant stuff for Fornaroli.
Borussia feeding Kelfalar at the other end. It's Dylan Manane on the overlap. Came off the chest of Retre. Now the counter perhaps on Aramoy. He'll look to go crossfield, and it's not a bad release. And it's Stephen Moore, chance for 2-2. How about that? What a comeback for Melbourne City. And in the Melbourne derby, it's a South Australian who draws the visitors level. 2-2 with 20 minutes to go. What a story.
Well, we've just watched Lazarus rise from the dead. I've got no problems, that's not a penalty. And why question brilliance? Everyone's wondering why Aaron Moy doesn't play a short five-metre pass there. That's why. He's dropped it over the top to Stephen Moore. A pinpoint accurate pass from the Socceroo midfielder. That is superb from Aaron Moy, and the finish ain't half bad either.
2 goals in 3 minutes has turned this derby completely on its head. And just by the by, a first A-League goal for Stephen Mawk as well. What a time to score it. Goodness me. We've had some storylines in the Melbourne derby down the years. And this is another one to add to the folklore. Marisha can't reach it. Tartalu finding Moy. Clever from Kuzmanovski. Launch forward by Kisnorbo. Return with interest by Georgievski. Russia scrapping for it, and it breaks for Finkler. With the outside of the boots, Melbourne Victoria on the attack all of a sudden. And it's Connor Payne, gets his head down, whips it across. There's the winner, surely, for Melbourne Victoria, and it's Bessar Berisha. Who else? He lives for days like these. He's not perhaps been at his best tonight, but he's then when it counted. 6 goals in his last 4 home derbies. And it could be the winner for Victory.
Well, he hit a beautiful header a few moments ago to force a great save from Thomas Sorensen. Finkler sticks it out wide. You can't beat speed and acceleration. And just look at what Connor Payne does here. Catch me if you can. And then slides it across the 6-yard box. Thomas Sorensen at full stretch can only finger the ball into the path of Bessar Berisha, who needs less of an opportunity, less of an invitation than that on big days. Great stuff, Connor Payne. Telling finish by Bessar Berisha.
Well, in truth, the final touch probably came off Jack Clisby, but you try taking that off Bessar Berisha. And probably cue an audible sigh of relief from those wearing navy blue, because this was a game that very nearly got away from Victory. They've not quite won it yet, but we are into 4 minutes of stoppage time. And all Melbourne City's work in trying to get back into the game may well count for nothing. Guy Finkler is going to be replaced for the final few moments by Jesse Makarounis. And it was he, the Brazilian, who started that move. A beautiful release for Connor Payne, and Berisha, as he so often is, was the Johnny on the spot. ...64 goals now in the Hyundai A-League. Goal number 6 for him in these derbies. Are City spent? Are they done? Here's Payne again, who claims an assist for what at the moment is the match-winning goal. Trying to tease his way past Retro, but they've given it away. Espindola. Bungled over by Del Pierre. That'll be a free kick, City.
Still time for Melbourne City. Do they have the belief? I reckon they'll get another opportunity or two at least.
Retray to angle it towards Kuzmanovski. And it'll pop for Aaron Moy. Attempted cross was blocked by Makarounis and hoiked to safety by Georgievski. Under 2 minutes remaining. What a second half we've had here. Flicked on by Tartalu, but nobody there for City. Danny Vukovic will take all the time he possibly can. John Van Schoop looks understandably rather crestfallen. And how'd you begin to sum this game
up? Well, apart from it being fantastic, but near enough is not going to be good enough for Melbourne City increasingly. And wonderful second half. Kevin Muscat's men have found something. And key substitutions, credit to both coaches, I guess. because their substitutes have made massive contributions. And Connor Payne put on what is shaping up as the winning goal for Besar Berisha. That'll be offside. They're just a pulsating 17th Melbourne derby.
Berisha carded in the closing moments, trying to hold up the restart. I don't think he'll care about that. 30 seconds remaining. City looking tired, but come from two goals down. Showing their steel in places. This is Moy. But they drag it back again. Clisby's delivery. Del Pierre's header only as far as Aaron Moy. Drop of the shoulder. Vital challenge by Georgievski, I think. And he's gone down injured. They're dropping like flies. All eyes on referee Jared Gillett. Flipped on towards Fornaroli. Could he turn it around? Is there a foul though by Deng? He's gone down on the deck.
Well, it's blood and gut stuff at the moment, Simon. Whistles coming from the victory supporters.
But not yet from the referee. We're into the fifth minute of stoppage time. There it goes. It's victory again. After a pulsating second half, normal service resumed in Melbourne. Victory win the derby for the third game in a row. And they've now triumphed in four of the last five. But boy, City made them work hard for it. After going two goals in front, they were pegged back. And well, might Kevin Muscat blow out his cheeks. They had to come again, but ultimately they did and got the winner through Besar Berisha. John Badskip can take heart from his team's performance, perhaps, as they head into that FFA Cup semi-final with Perth during the week. And they may well do it all again, of course, in the Cup final against Victory. But if City have title aspirations, well, first, they've got to get past their nearest neighbours. Melbourne is navy blue yet again tonight. Final scoreline at Etihad Stadium. Melbourne Victory 3, Melbourne City 2.